We have 31 firefighters that are about to land from Los Angeles.
You know, when there's fire anywhere, firefighters generally want to go help.
We've seen Australian folks in the States before, so yeah, just glad to be here.
I was asked to come to Australia to work as a liaison officer. It's been a warm welcome across the board for all the Americans that have been here. I started fire in 1991. As far as the large scale fires across the landscape, it's something that I haven't seen before. I've got 5 kids running around, and my wife obviously has to manage that. That's something that we need to slow down and think about, is the toll that it takes on a family when we are gone for a 30-day assignment. I know that my daughters are proud that I'm in Australia. All of my family is.
And came to Australia to help out with the situation that's going on here.
As far as the fire intensity, it was some of the most intense fire I've ever seen in my 25 plus years of fighting fire. The sheer magnitude of what was happening on those days across the entire country, I think, was pretty unprecedented, and we were essentially kind of running out of stuff. Like, we just didn't have more stuff. We didn't have more fire trucks or anything, because it was, you know, basically from Victoria all the way up to Queensland on those days was on fire, and so we were just kind of competing for resources, and everybody was having a bad day. There was one point when we ran out of water. We were just out of water, and sort of felt defeated, I think. And this is where I got my first taste of an actual Australian ember attack. And it felt like somebody was just throwing rocks that were on fire at you. There was a lot of neighbors helping neighbors, people helping folks. You know, the volunteer RFS program is incredible with the amount of people who are volunteering to help. You know, it was absolutely heartbreaking to get that news that night. That was really a gut-wrenching moment that lasted for quite some time after that. The group that came over when I came over, we're definitely feeling it. We're fatigued. But I can't imagine what it's like for some of the local firefighters here that have done 4 months of this.
Me and the brigade have been out for about the last month, a bit worn down, a bit sick of it, but yeah, just do what you gotta do. Eric's been on this side working with us for the last couple of weeks. Oh, he's been an enormous help to everyone on this side. Hopefully we'll repay the favour one day.
I think that the attention that has come to Australia is because of the sheer size and scope and duration of the wildfire event that has happened. People are just stepping forward and doing something. If more of that happened, we'd have a lot better world.